Live from Blunt Garage, you're listening to Right Hand Drive Guys. I'm Bobby. This is Aaron.
Yo, yo.
And this is episode 42.
Yep.
That's really
42.
Cool.
We're getting up there.
Yeah, we are. And this is the Don't Kill Daikoku episode.
Yes, dude.
Yeah. I didn't even lay that on you before we started, but I figured I'd hit
yeah,
you with it.
Yeah, don't
now.
Kill it.
Yeah, exactly. Dude. And so a lot of guys or girls listening probably know what and where Daikoku is for the most part. Some of you have been there. Most of you probably haven't. But we're going to kind of lay it all out and let you know why the episode's even called Don't Kill Daikoku.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
So Daikoku is a PA. What's a PA?
PA stands for parking area.
Yeah, and it's not like the parking area you're thinking necessarily on 95 or whatever, you know,
yeah.
40, whatever interstates where you're at. It's, they're different over there.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. I mean, they're similar, you know, as far as like the concept, I guess you could say.
Right.
You know, they're areas that are only accessible by car because they're off a highway, just like they are in the States.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, regular, even just regular, you know, road traffic can't get on it. You have to exit and enter on using an interstate.
Right, right.
So that's one thing about them that's kind of similar to the ones in the States. But as Japan is, they go way harder in their parking areas.
Way harder. So you're going to find not only, of course, you know, bathrooms, that's going to be the base, but then there's the whole everything else, like
yeah.
the shopping, the food. Like, they got shopping in there.
Yeah, yeah. It's insane. Like, I've never experienced anything like these in my life,
mm-hmm.
at any of them that we, like, stopped by. And, like, the closest thing I could kind of relate it to is, like, a Buc-ee's or something in the United States. Which,
sure.
Which is kind of...
But
that's still
kind like,
of
gas station-y.
Right, that's yeah. more of a truck stop. I mean,
yeah.
these places, like, have these specialty things that are, like, from that region that they're in.
Yep.
And just, like...
Like,
dude,
the dankest Wagyu jerky. Like,
dude, yeah.
yeah, the coolest ice creams. Like, drinks galore. Vending machines outside the,
yeah.
like, lining the place.
Right.
And Ferris wheels?
Yeah, Ferris wheels. Yeah,
Ferris
we stopped at
wheels.
One... on the Tomei Expressway.
Yep.
It's at the base of Fuji. And, like, that one has, like, all kinds of souvenirs and stuff about Fuji. Like, has a place you can go upstairs and have, like, a picture of it. Like,
oh, yeah.
It's hard to explain, but they, like, put
like
a
an
sticker
observation
on,
type
yeah, yeah,
thing,
yeah.
right?
They put a sticker on the window and it has a heart, and you take a picture of the window, and it, like,
it has
whatever.
Fuji
yeah.
in it. Yeah,
it has
yeah.
Fuji in it. It's, like,
cute.
Whatever. Yeah, cute. But... Yeah, I mean, it just goes to show, like, how they do things. And that's not the only one that's like that. Like, the one at Ebina is famous for, like, the melon pond.
Yeah, 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 for sure. And but Daikoku is a little different. Not so much shopping. There's a 24-hour
right.
Lawson's. But, the, you know, there's more, like, some food and other things.
Right.
But not as much shopping and specialty
right.
stuff. It seems more of... I wouldn't say a quicker stop,
yeah.
but it's not off the side of a long haul.
Right, right. It's like right in the Yokohama Bay, right? So
yeah.
it's right outside of Tokyo.
Yeah, Bayshore Route, baby.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. you know.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. And so that's, everybody knows it goes to Daikoku. It's off the Bayshore Route. You
yeah.
hit the Bayshore Route and take that PA exit, not the Daikoku Futo exit,
yeah.
which is actually down at the pier.
Right, right. Because
yeah.
this is like an industrial area.
Yeah, it's not where you'd normally see these PAs that we're talking about. It's definitely more, yeah, industrial commercial.
Right, right.
And so, yeah, basically 20 minutes out of like the middle of Tokyo, maybe
yeah.
25.
Depending on traffic.
Right, yeah, right in the bay. And it's kind of, and I'll try to attach some pictures on YouTube, but it's kind of like goes, or the interstate like circles around it, the entrance
yeah.
and exit. So when you're standing in this place, all up around you is like concrete ramps and
right.
like pretty high.
Yeah, pretty high up. And dude, like the closest thing I can even relate to is like, it reminds you of like some old video game. Like,
yeah,
some Sega video game where, you know, just like all these colors and like all these crazy stripes on the road.
Yeah.
Like, just, I don't know. Just, it looks so different. That like exit area.
Yeah.
Looks completely different than any other part of, that I've seen even in Tokyo.
Right.
It's kind of crazy.
Yeah, it is different. And
so when you see it, you definitely know you're there.
And it's pretty big. It's got like 340 spots for cars and
yeah,
another 60 for long trailer trucks.
Yeah.
Which, decent, you know, that's, yeah, it's, that's pretty large. Two different sets of bathrooms. It's, so it's a cool place. I mean, in tons of vending machines, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
And the spots are in like, I don't know, I would say 40 long rows or so, like back and forth.
Yeah.
And you kind of have to drive like around, like
back
you can't,
and forth over,
yes,
some speed bumps.
You
every
do
day.
It, and it's one way, so you have to, it kind of stinks in that sense. But yeah, I mean, I like it, of course, right?
Yeah, yeah, I think it's pretty sick.
And
like, it's one of those places where it's been around for so long that if you were on the forums back in the day, you would always see the photos of the car meets there.
Right.
And you would always know that it was there because of, like you said, like the exit ramp getting down, how it circles around the entire place. And like,
yeah,
whatever that tower thing is in the middle, what, I'm,
it's
not sure.
It's a light and speaker tower.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah. So, and seeing that, I mean, it's just so iconic. You like, when you see pictures from there, you know that's Daikoku.
Yeah.
And no matter what kind of car is there, it could be,
there's a any kind,
California State Trooper car, like,
yep,
Dodge Charger, or there could be some crazy supercar you've never even seen before.
Yeah.
Like, it's just crazy to all the things that show up there as well.
Yeah, and so when we went to Japan, we were there 4 or 5 nights or so. In,
yeah,
in my most recent trip, we went 3 nights, and it's wild. It was wild when we went.
Yeah.
But it's like way more wild now in the sense of spectators, I would call it spectators, not necessarily, definitely a lot of them were not people with cars,
yeah,
there, you know, whether they rode with somebody or got a taxi in, which you,
yeah,
you don't do.
Usually they don't, like, I've heard of stories of people trying to get taxis down there, but like, the cab drivers don't understand why you want to go to a parking area to be dropped off because it makes no sense.
Right, so you got to tell them that you're meeting somebody there and that's where they
right,
wanted you to meet them.
Yeah, I mean, and like, there's no buses to go to this place. There's
right,
no
public
not a train
transportation.
Station.
It's like, it's just like, it's like we were talking about with the PA. Most of them are simply just for cars to stop off,
yeah,
get your drink, take a nap, which most of them are.
Right.
You know, a lot of them that we went to, that's exactly what's happening constantly.
Yeah, yeah.
A few of them, you know, after dark, of course, not just Daikoku. Daikoku is just the most, like, talked about and, like,
right,
kind of publicized.
Right, right.
Parking,
and especially
area,
being, like, right close to the Wangon, the C1, like.
Yeah, it was the stop off
iconic
back in the day for,
yeah,
everybody, and that's where they met up. That's how, of course, that's how Daikoku started,
right,
was the racers, the serious guys, the underground guys, and then it becomes a legend,
right,
and like any legend, everybody wants a piece of that legend.
Yeah, yeah.
But there's a difference. There's a difference between people who want a piece of the legend but respect it,
yeah,
and somebody who's maybe chasing clout or doesn't understand Japanese customs, doesn't respect it. There's
right,
two different types of people.
100%.
Yeah.
You know, there can be people. Yeah, there's definitely two type of people that go there, and it's like the people that do respect it, understand it, love the culture, and then there's the guy just trying to get the video no matter what, if he's standing on the on-ramp of the of the highway or whatever it is, and just kind of more or less ruining it, right?
Yeah, pretty much turning it into something it never was supposed to be, even after the racers had stopped going there because too many people were coming. Even after the underground guys found a new spot,
yeah,
people kept going there and it kept getting bigger, right?
Yeah.
And now you have this, as I said, like, legend that has almost outgrown itself,
yeah,
to an extent. So when we went, you know, on a Saturday night when we were there, it was bumping. You know, it was cool, and there was some spectators for sure.
Right.
When Bella and I went on this Thursday, it was gross. It was ridiculous. Like, it was hard. There was so many people. So basically the way that Daikoku works is on the front side of it is where the entrance comes in.
Yeah.
And then there's four entrances into the parking lot on your right that you can take, spaced out because of the other side that comes around. So there's this big patch when you first drive in to your right before that first turn in. And this was like, people were packed like it was a train. Like, I'm serious. I was
on this little island.
On the little island, yeah. And I'm Whoa. Just like, what is going on with this? Like, why is so many people here? So I'm thinking, like, you know, I'm trying to think and I'm trying to find a spot. Super hard to find a spot.
Yeah.
Place was packed on a Thursday night. And so all those people, like I said, standing there, they didn't have a car there, most of them. All the guys with cars were talking to other guys with cars like it was meant to be.
Yeah.
It was never meant to be a car show.
Right.
It was meant to be like dudes hanging, meet and like conversing and talking about parts and, you know, strategies, whatever it may be.
Yeah.
Now it has definitely turned into like, what are we going to see? You know, like Skyline Supras and everything in between, you know, and they're there, like we said, kind of for some for the clout, some for the genuine. Some of them are the people that respect.
Right.
Right. Because just because they want the video of the Skyline pulling in doesn't mean that they aren't like respectful.
Yeah.
We'll get to the people that aren't respectful.
Yeah.
I'm simply saying this comparatively to when we were there on a Saturday night, you know, 6 or 7 months later, on a Thursday night is worse than, like, in the sense of spectators.
Yeah.
And
that's insane.
Again, I get it. Like, you know, we're not all so lucky to have a Skyline there that we can go drive.
Right.
Like, respect. Like, 100%. You rent a car.
Yeah.
You.
It's that easy.
You join an experience which brings you there in a car. Make a friend.
Right.
Those are kind of the three things. Get a car, join an experience, get a friend.
Yeah, and the experience thing, that's fairly easy to come by. Like,
yeah.
Albo does it, obviously, right?
Yeah, like, and I think that's on kind of the higher end of the experience.
Yeah,
like,
for sure.
Scale, because we were just looking. We just typed in Daikoku on Google.
Dude, we just typed it in, Daikoku parking area.
Never ending. Just, it was like sponsored,
tours.
Sponsored tours. And there's like tours nonstop. We're just like.
Yeah, what? And someone included a car rental.
Yeah.
So like, you know, anywhere between, I think it was what, $50 up to several hundred.
Yeah.
Like, you can spend and like do this type of thing correctly.
Right. Yeah.
You know, in the sense of renting a car, driving to the parking area, hanging out with the car, whatever.
Having somebody experienced, you know,
having someone that
teach
knows
you
the culture,
how to handle it.
Yeah. Yes.
That's,
right.
That's the big thing, because that's what's killing Daikoku,
right,
is the people that see it on Instagram, see it on Twitter, TikTok, you know, YouTube, and they're like, we're hitting that.
Yeah.
Dope. That's a great idea to start.
Yeah.
But then they just try to hit it, and then they end up down there on the outside of the fence.
Yeah.
And so, like Aaron mentioned earlier, Daikoku, you cannot get into from the pier side, which means no local road will take you there. And when we were first meeting there, I took the local road, not realizing I took the Daikoku Futo exit.
Right.
And so I end up down on the outside of it, exactly where, you know, some of these events have happened that, you know, have led to us even talking about this.
Yeah.
I'm on the outside over there, and it's kind of daunting because, you know, I took the Apple directions and I put Daikoku parking area, and it brings me on the outside. no way to get in besides go out and around onto the highway, come around, you know.
A few tolls later.
Right, and also being my first time there. Right. I had no clue. So I can see how some of these guys are getting in these situations, but their actions based on that is what is creating the problem.
Right. You got to be smarter about it.
Yeah, and so we can, before we really get into the nitty-gritty of what the problem is and how to solve it, what is some of the best things about Daikoku? Like, what have you seen there that was, like, mind-blowing? You know, on the car guy side of things, the reason why everybody wants to come here in the first place.
Yeah.
What are some of the things you've seen?
I would think it's just the vibe of the place. I mean, one, like, you're in the middle of, or not in the middle, but you're in Tokyo, you're in Japan, you're seeing all these crazy cars you've always seen online, or, you know, you're just in this super iconic place that just might mean more to you because of whatever you've seen your favorite car here before, or just all those type of things, right? Mm-hmm. That kind of plays into the vibe. And then on top of that, just like seeing the car culture there firsthand and just how vast it can be and how vast, like, just how random some of the cars can be there.
Oh,
like,
for sure. You can see
at any given time.
Yes, you can see everything there. It's a lot of, like, import, you know, quote unquote cars, but you're gonna see other things. Like, I'll patch in a video here on YouTube of the Charger with Lambo doors, and you know, and then right next to it is a M Speckner.
Yeah.
And so it's just like, it's kind of crazy because their love of the machine is so expansive.
Yeah.
Like, no matter what they have, they pretty much mod it.
Yeah.
The guys that are into it.
Right.
You know, whether it's a little K car or it's a S15.
Yeah, they do it up 100%. And then on top of that, like, there's also the Lawsons. They have Dank Chicken.
Yeah, they do. They have Dank Chicken, some good on Geary, like.
Yeah, for sure. And then the vending machines.
Yeah.
And then,
dude, of course, like, you
the
got
bathrooms there,
right there
are mint.
So sick. You,
dude,
you got the, yeah.
I know it sounds crazy, but, like, for a car guy that's into Japanese stuff, like, it's kind of a one-stop shop in that sense, right? You can get, like, 90% of the stuff that you see on Instagram in one stop, right?
Yeah.
You get the cars, you get the, you know, konbini food, the in the vending machines, like.
Yeah, you
and
do.
The bidet, you know, if you go to the bath.
Yeah, the Toto, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it does, and that's just really on one side, and then on the other side, there's two actual restaurants and more bathrooms. So, yeah, I mean, it is, I guess, that perfect spot, and it not being in the actual center, but being in, like, the southwest part of Tokyo, it kind of keeps it out of the hustle and bustle so that maybe you're not drawing so much attention.
Yeah.
But one thing we haven't mentioned, what else is at Daikoku?
What else is at Daikoku?
The friggin' police station.
Oh, yeah. The police station. There's
the
a police
station
there.
Yeah,
100%.
Literally.
It's like, it's kind of hidden, right? It's like behind some bushes or something.
Underneath one of the bridges,
Yeah, and then you're like, wait a minute.
Why?
That's a police station.
These vehicles are, like, pulling out of there. Like, so, you know, so Daikoku used to never get shut down, so I was told that, like, back in the day, and even just, you know, before COVID, they wouldn't really get shut down.
Yeah.
Unless it was, like, out of control, or, like, there was any sort of, like, the racing burnout type thing. They do not like the racing. They do not like the burnouts.
Yeah.
Like any law enforcement, right?
Right.
You know, so.
Yeah.
But I guess they used to not. But now what'll happen is, and so when we were there, it was Golden Week. More people were out. We were there on the weekend. It got shut down, like, 10 o'clock about, you know, they.
Right.
But this last trip, 8:30.
Holy
cow. I was like, you know, on a Thursday.
They're getting that strict, huh?
Yeah. And so I think that, you know, this is what this is all leading into, but this is getting out of control.
Yeah.
You know, to their their point, you know, especially with what you're saying. Some of these guys are on the on or off ramp taking pictures, trying to get that perfect reel or whatever it may be. And what they're doing is creating a hassle for local law enforcement. And no matter what you think, PA, you're right, whatever, they're local law enforcement.
Yeah.
They trump you. They live there.
Yeah, literally.
Yeah.
Like,
they live there. So now it's turned back to 8:30. And like I said, a whole median, well, two really, because there's one full median at the entrance, one at the exit, because people want those shots, right? And then there's people sprinkled all through the other 340 spots.
Yeah, yeah.
And so it's kind of one of those things. You've got the police on site. They literally hide their vehicles until they are ready to come out. One will come out at first, and he'll put on his little light, and he'll yell out on the bullhorn.
Which sounds super intimidating.
Yeah, it does.
I don't know why, but just the way their tone of voice is when they start, like...
Yeah, it's like
sounding
they
off,
send
dude,
out the
like,
guy
whoa.
With the, like,
okay,
monster
yes,
voice.
Sir.
Yeah, you kind of pucker and you, like, head to the car. And I'm like, dude, what? Not you, but, yeah, it's like, dude, what are you doing? No, I'm out of here, bro.
Yeah. And then they hit the siren, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Something about that siren, too, is just,
it's
like.
Different. It hits different.
It does hit different, dude. Yeah. It's just like, what's
shit,
happening, dude?
Arrested?
Like, what's going to happen? Like, I don't know. It sounds kind of scary, but no, it's just the meat getting shut down.
Yeah. And so what ends up happening is they have these Toyotas that they have a sign that comes up out of the back of it in the lights are on it, and it extends the lights up so that you can see them even more, and it has a bullhorn on it. And so what they'll do is at the entrance, they'll go drive around, they'll go park at the entrance so that you have to go around to the exit. You can't come in anymore.
I see.
You have to turn right and head out the exit.
Yeah.
And so that's how they stop the cars coming in. So the first one is dude telling people to leave. Second one is the guy that blocks the entrance.
Yep.
Third one, they get through. They have three cars. They drive around and they'll say the same thing again, but now with more force, right?
Yeah.
So that's like warning three. Right. And so a lot of people just don't want to deal with it and they start leaving. And that's what we did the first time.
Yeah.
Well, what ended up happening with Bella and I is we were up at the bathroom and at the Lawson's. We went after the first single guy came and the one that parks and puts up the light.
Yeah.
We went to the Lawson's in the bathroom because she's an 11-year-old girl. She had to go to the bathroom, and I'm getting some onigiri. So we missed the three, you know, because we were in there for quite a while, actually. And when we come out, they're doing this thing where they got, like, 12 guys, and they pretty much, like, all walk the parking lot, and they yell, and whose car is this? Go. And
holy
they
cow.
Pretty much kick you out, like, in, like, a wave. And so we're parked like four rows back and like they're in like the first or second row and we're walking there and they're like getting up to the car and I'm getting in the car as they start walking up and he's like,
whatever
he's saying, pretty much like going, I'm like, I'm out, dude. Like, I'm out. You know, just because they are like, it does seem, especially to people that maybe aren't involved with law enforcement and like whatever, it does seem like aggressive.
Right.
And with my 11-year-old there, I'm like, oh, she's gonna think this is bad. Like, let's get out of here.
Right. Oh, remember the time that we went, the time that it was shut down? We had parked the camper there.
Oh, like, Lord.
Like, the day before, like, way earlier in the day. We came back at night. It had been shut down, dude. The complete parking lot is empty.
Empty besides...
besides the camper, dude. You
it's
drop
just like
me
a
off
sore
and you're
thumb.
Like, good luck.
Yeah. And, I mean, they, like, stare you down but let you out, right?
Yeah, they didn't say anything to me. I walked right past them. I was trying to gaijin my way out of it.
Yeah. As we've been told, just gaijin your way out of it.
Right. But they didn't stop me. And I hopped right in, drove right past them, and was on my way. But it was kind of scary. I was like, which one of these dudes is going to drop me with some nunchucks or something?
Seriously. Like, yeah, I mean, that's way better than that one night when we pulled in, you know, looking for a meet and it had been shut down. So you could still pull into the trailer truck spots, but like yeah. not, you're not, it was really for trailer trucks, right?
Right.
Rest stop, right? So I pull off to the left side of that parking area, kind of in the throughway.
Yeah.
And I just pulled off to get directions to where the Hardcore Underground or whatever meet was.
Yeah.
Or the Tokyo Underground. And dude, all of a sudden the trailer truck's like, bang, bang. And I like just about like shit my pants.
Dude,
I'm like, holy
yeah.
shit. And so I'm like waving out the window, telling him like, go by, because he could go by, but he
was
like, I don't know what his deal was. So of course the big honk honk gets the police's attention.
Dude, right?
And so I'm telling this guy to wave by, and all of a sudden these like, what was it, two or three of them?
Two
of them start like running at us, kind of, and
blowing whistles.
Yes, and
like
shaking their little lighted baton thing at us. And I'm like, one minute, and they're basically, they're like, no, get out, like told me to go. And I'm like, okay, dude, like, I'm out of here. But so Daikoku is cool, but now there's a police presence, right?
Yeah.
And the reason for that is, what do you think?
Gaijins.
Yeah,
the foreigners, kind of.
The
you
foreigners,
know, just kinda...
the new people, the people that, like we said, they didn't take the time to really, and they didn't invest the time into that trip right there.
Right. I mean, I think it's the people jumping the fences.
Yeah.
And,
yeah,
you know,
I would say.
Getting dropped off down there and not having a ride out. And
yeah.
Like, that's just
that's
a headache
foolish.
For all. Yeah, I know. It is, dude. It's, but I think that definitely has something to do with the presence, you know? I mean.
Yeah.
And plus.
I mean, that's definitely it. And just imagine to the locals what you seem like, dude.
Yeah, I know.
When you don't have a ride out of Daikoku, and then you're getting desperate. You're asking those people that are now starting to take off,
Right. Can
I get a ride? They're like.
Could you
Dude.
Imagine if you did that at your local meet? Like, if someone just came up out of nowhere, barely spoke the language, and was asking you for a ride, or, like, just
with
being
their phone, basically.
Like, breaking into the place, and then, like, asking you for a ride on Translate, and, like, trying to do this thing. Could you imagine how crazy you would look at them? Because that's how crazy they're going to look at you.
Yeah, because they don't know you.
They don't know you, right?
They don't know you got a 350Z back home that you drift and you always love Fast and Furious. They got no clue.
Right.
They just are like, all right, bud, like, no, you know, and probably brush you off. And then you're like, oh, Japanese dudes are jerks. Well, no, dude, you're just out of line.
Yeah. You gotta come correct, you know? And, like, that was one of the things that kind of, I don't know, learned pretty quick about Japan, is you got to forget everything you know about home. And, like, all your customs back home don't mean shit to them over there.
Exactly.
And
you're, like, not entitled to nothing there.
You gotta move like they do when you're over there. And you
or at least
in
put
mind.
In the effort. And that's it. What this all boils down to is lack of effort on some of these guys' parts that's just so excited to come that they don't understand this part. Like, you're walking into Japan. Okay.
Yeah.
You are on their turf.
Right.
You gotta act like that.
Right.
Don't it's not the local ball field. You're not climbing the fence to go play catch, dude. Like, you're climbing literal 12 or 14. It's a huge fence.
Yeah, it's insane. I was like, those dudes are brave, like
no, like,
what?
Like,
like, holy cow, dude.
That Supra's dope, dude, but it's not that cool or whatever.
Seriously.
You're going to see, like, And really, again, they take pride in their property. They take pride in their cars. They take pride in their culture and customs. So you're straight up disrespecting them.
Yeah,
100%. And you don't even know it. You're just so focused on a car or whatever you want to see.
Yeah, you're just so tunnel visioned. Like, which, yeah, I get it. But, like, take a step back.
Right.
Think a little bit. Like, think about what you're doing. Think about where you are. Think about how far away from home you are.
Yeah.
Because, I don't know. I don't know what Japanese jail cells are like, but
I'm not trying to break into
a car meet.
No way. And so what you're really doing, and what you got to really realize by making these, like, avoidable mistakes, is you're pushing the dope cars out of there. The dope car, let me tell you something, and we could have a whole nother episode, I'm sure, on this. The dope cars aren't at Daikoku anymore.
No.
They're not. They're at their own small exclusive meets because they truly want to talk to each other and hang out with cars. They don't want like the crowd. They don't want your pictures. They don't want. They don't need any of that.
Yeah.
They're not going to Daikoku anymore. They might swing by. They may drive through
on Seven's Day or you know, some special occasion.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, for the most part, yeah, those dudes aren't going.
Yeah, they're like, probably at a parking garage over in this area, you know, 30 of them, whatever. Right. But, yeah, it's pushing it further and further out. And so what you're really doing is affecting the culture in, like, a negative way. And eventually you're going to kill Daikoku.
100%.
Yeah, and then what? I mean, yeah, it's the next parking area. Like they do. That's what the locals, that's what the dudes with the super dope cars, they went on to the next and probably the next already, you know, because word always gets around when it comes to sick cars.
Right.
It's how it is. So, I mean, I don't know. I'd be real sad if they shut down Daikoku like that. I mean, again, they've already gone an hour and a half earlier than just when we were there.
Yeah, I would be pretty upset. I mean, just because of how iconic it is. And it's one of those things that's like, it's the only place like it in the world.
Literally.
Don't fuck it up.
Yes, like, with your weird, skewed sense of entitlement or whatever you got. Yeah. And so what? They put out some sort of warning, right?
Yeah, yeah. The high, I forget the word they call it, but pretty much like the highway patrol or whatever for that area or for that expressway put out a warning in English.
English, that tells you a lot.
Yeah, so it pretty much just said, you know, explained that there were people trying to jump the fences, people that were showing up that don't have rides, like
the whole thing that we just went
the whole thing that
much.
We just went over. And like if like the government, if the DOT is putting out like a statement against these people doing these things, must be pretty important. Like,
yeah, that means that it's gotten out of hand.
Yeah, for sure. So
they posted the video of the people trying to climb the fence.
Dude, yeah. And then the police rolling up on them.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
dude,
I mean,
I'd hate to be those kids like right now.
Yeah,
like,
no doubt.
Imagine you're on the infomercial or whatever for something not to do.
Yeah, exactly. About your favorite or people's favorite place. Yeah, and so, you know, of course it just comes down to respect and being like a good human being and suppressing some of your feelings to think straight.
Yeah, yeah.
But you're going to have a lot of people not liking you if you kill Daikoku.
Yeah, 100%. And I've seen a lot of the locals in Japan like say the same thing about it, like that shared that video and then put their two cents in on it. Mm-hmm. And they're just like, you foreigners got to chill.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's an amazing place, but like, just chill. Like, chill. Right, exactly. Respect. Right. And that's the biggest thing, respect it. Don't go to Daikoku and come without the respect.
Right. Keep that at your local takeover or whatever.
Whatever, yeah. Because Japan doesn't play that.
No.
But it's a little sidebar. The cops were like definitely on anyone racing. Like I heard sirens like consistently for that. And
really?
you'd hear the revs, all of a sudden you'd hear the sirens blowing. So I think they're even cracking down on that facet of it because I think that the sounds, because like we said, it's a big enclosed concrete thing. Somebody, when they race, you hear it like you're at the strip. It's crazy. It like echoes perfectly in there, so I think that helps draw people because that's another sense that like is heightened when you're hearing that constantly.
Yeah.
You know, but yeah. So from everybody that respects Daikoku, please don't kill it.
Yeah,
for
don't
us.
Kill it, dude. Just chill out.
Just chill.
Just chill.
Yeah.
Just chill.
And. So don't forget, you know, you can hit us on the Instagram at Blunt Garage at RHDGUIS for right-hand drive guys. Hit up the link tree in the bio. We got the merch in there. And also you can sub us on the YouTube if you want, but we appreciate you listening.
Yeah, absolutely.
And for episode 42, I'm Bobby. This is Aaron.
See ya.
Don't kill Daikoku.